$8.8 billion is a lot of money. Most of us will never see that much in our entire lives. And anybody who has that much is basically set for life. If you had $8.8 billion, what would you do with it? Honestly, what is there that you couldn't do with that much money? Unfortunately, that amount of money is not a good thing. At least, not in the context of this lesson. According to the Federal Trade Commission, $8.8 billion is the amount of money that was reported stolen by scammers in 2022. And if that's only the amount that was reported, the actual amount is probably even higher. Keep watching to learn how you can keep your money from becoming part of that statistic. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to identify the warning signs of common online scams and respond appropriately to suspected scams to avoid becoming a victim. Let's get into it. Scammers existed long before the internet was invented, but it was a lot harder to trick people in person. The internet gave scammers a way to more efficiently hide their real identity, target anybody around the world, and disappear with other people's money without a trace. Luckily, knowledge is power. The key to protecting yourself from getting scammed is educating yourself on what a scam looks like. For instance, scams can look like this. I know it looks like a typical email from your favorite learning platform, but there are a few hints here that this is actually a phishing scam. That's phishing with a PH. Phishing scams trick you into giving up your own login details or payment information. For instance, if you click the link in this email, it takes you to a fake version of our website, and when you type in your password, it will send that password to a hacker so they can log into your account. Phishing scams can come in any form: email, text, social media comments, or even direct messages. Luckily, most phishing scams have similar features that are a dead giveaway. Phishing scams come out of nowhere and usually require you to click links. So the number one tip for avoiding phishing scams is don't click links in unexpected messages. If a website sends you an email once a week with their latest deals, that's an expected message. If a friend tells you they're going to send you something and then they do, that's expected. But if you get a message out of the blue and they ask for you to click a link, that's a major red flag that you might be dealing with a scam. If you still aren't sure, double check that the sender is who they say they are. When it comes to suspicious emails from a company, that's easy. Just click the sender's name. Scammer email addresses tend to look like random gibberish, like this, while real email addresses are short and simple, like this one. Typically, official company emails will even end with a domain related to the company, which makes it easy to tell at a glance whether it's a scam. For messages from friends or family, it's a little trickier because their account may have been hacked. If a message seems suspicious, ask if it was them through some other method, like a phone call or a text. If they say no, then that's a sure sign that it was a scam. Scammers try to direct you to fake websites, but it's also possible to end up on them totally by accident. Scammers create fake versions of popular websites with URLs that are just slightly off. That way, if somebody trying to go to Mia Academy makes a typo, they won't realize they ended up on the wrong site. They'll enter their login information, and just like with phishing, now a hacker has those details and can hack that person's account. So what can you do to avoid falling for fake websites? The most important thing is to always double check the URL before you type anything in. You should be looking for two things. First, is the domain itself correct? Remember, scammers take advantage of typos, so if the domain isn't 100% correct, re-enter it correctly. Second, is the website secure? Do you remember how to tell if a website is secure? A secure website starts with HTTPS, not just HTTP. If the scheme doesn't have that S for secure, avoid typing in any information that you wouldn't want getting stolen. Another common scam is the romance or friendship scam. With this scam, you meet a new friend online and really hit it off. Over time, they become one of the best friends you've ever had, and maybe it even turns into a long-distance dating type situation. After you've known each other for a while, they want to finally meet you in person, but alas, they can't afford a plane ticket. Would you be willing to spare a measly $800 if it meant seeing your best friend in the world or the love of your life? And then once you send them the money for a plane ticket, you wait, excited for them to finally arrive. And you wait. And wait. And wait. But they never arrive. You go to message them to find out where they are, but there's no reply. It's like they've disappeared with your money. No two romance scams are the same. It's not always money for a plane ticket. Sometimes it's a sudden emergency hospital bill that they can't afford. Or maybe they've been arrested for a crime they didn't commit and they need money for a lawyer. Whatever their story is, it will be designed to make it impossible for a good person like you to say no. So, what can you do to avoid being taken advantage of by a romance scam? First, if you meet somebody online, use whatever information the other person has given you to verify that they are who they say they are. In other words, snoop on them. Look them up online and see if the information they've given you matches what they've told you. If not, that's a big red flag that they might be a scammer. Even if they aren't a scammer, let's be real. Somebody lying to you is not a good foundation for any relationship, even a long-distance relationship. And of course, if they ask you to send them money or do anything illegal, don't. You might be tempted because you care about them and they say they really need your help. But a real, genuine person will understand if you're hesitant, whereas a scammer will just get mad that their scam failed, and then they'll probably ghost you. Adios, scammer. With the rise of online shopping, shopping scams have become a major risk when using the internet. They aren't even that hard to do either. Put a high-value item up for sale for dirt cheap and then wait for victims to order the item thinking they're getting a great deal. The trick, of course, is that shoppers pay for the item and then don't actually get it. Best case scenario, you gave somebody a small amount of money for a terrible knockoff. Or you may even get nothing at all. Worst case scenario, you entered your payment details into a totally fake shopping website, and now the scammer is using your money to pay for whatever they want. So, how can you tell whether an item online is safe to purchase? One way is by always checking reviews, both of the item and the seller, before purchasing anything online. Some of the things that can send up red flags include identical or nearly identical reviews, which might be fake, a bunch of reviews posted around the same time, which also might be fake, or a total lack of negative reviews, which might mean the seller has been deleting bad reviews to trick future buyers. Personally, I don't trust anything with a perfect rating. The scams presented in this video are only the really common scams. There are tons of other types of online scams out there, not to mention all the different variations of each type. With so many scams out there, how could you possibly avoid all of them? Well, it's actually pretty simple. There are some red flags that present in almost every scam. For instance, scammers have to make their offer difficult for victims to turn down. So scams will typically be too good to be true, like the love of your life or a once-in-a-lifetime deal on something really cool. If something seems too good to be true, that might be because it is. Scams also tend to have a sense of urgency. Scammers don't want to give you a chance to stop and think, so they'll impose a strict time limit for you to make a decision. This can look like a definitive time limit, or it can be a vague, do this quickly, or else something bad will happen. If somebody doesn't want to give you a chance to stop and think, that's a huge red flag. Unfortunately, not all hackers rely on malware or scams to get through your digital defenses. Some of them weasel their way in the old-fashioned method by figuring out your password. In the next lesson, you'll learn how to add extra security to your accounts to make it even harder for hackers to get in, even if they do manage to guess your password. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.